What is going on, everybody? Stas here. Welcome back to another video. So in today's video, just like always, guys, just like every single Sunday, I'm going to be breaking down the top couple of stocks and ETFs that I'm personally watching heading into this upcoming week, being the third week in August in 2019, as well as breaking down some stocks and ETFs that you guys ended up calling out on Friday's video. Actually, no, on Saturday's video in the comment section, in the call-out section in our Discord group chat, or on Instagram in the DMs. So if you guys did end up calling out a stock on any of these platforms, I really do appreciate it, and I will be getting to those stocks or ETFs in this video. So if you guys find value in this video, feel free to go down below, hit that like button, consider subscribing if you want to see further content from me, and drop a comment. Let me know what your thoughts are on the market right now. Where do you think we're headed this week? What stocks and ETFs are you trading? I would love to know. And without further ado, guys, let's just get right into it. So I decided to wait until 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time today to record this video because I wanted to see what the futures were going to open up at. And for those of you guys that don't know, the futures market, it opens up at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Sunday. And we get to see where the S&P's at, where gold is at, where the NASDAQ's at, where the Dow's that, and a bunch of other futures, right? And we can see here the ES, the E-mini S&P 500 index futures, they're currently up $12.50, up 0.43%. So it's continuing that nice little run from Friday. For those of you guys that paid attention to the markets on Friday, we saw a nice, pretty amazing, honestly, green day of 41 points in the S&P 500. So we are continuing that rally from Friday as of right now. And remember, guys, a lot of things can change. Just because the futures are green right now, that doesn't mean the market's going to be green all day tomorrow, right? For all we know, the market could be red tomorrow, but as of now, the futures are green. And if we go to the NASDAQ very quickly here, slash NQ, we're up about the same point in terms of percentage, right? 0.42%. We're up $31.50 here. And if we go to the Dow Jones Industrial Average Index futures here, they're currently up actually more. They're up 0.5%, 0.50 to be exact, up 129 points. So as of now, guys, the markets are, they're gapping up, right? They're continuing this rally that they saw on Friday, and I'm interested to see, you know, if this continues into tomorrow, this may open up some opportunities to day trade, maybe short-term swing trade some of these larger cap stocks that have been getting crushed over the past couple of weeks, you know, kind of as the market has been getting killed, you know, with the trade war tensions. We got the inverted yield curve and all the crazy stuff that's been going on in the markets. And if you guys want to see a more in-depth, a talk in terms of what the market has been up to, go check out yesterday's video. I'll link it down below in the description box for those of you guys that are interested. I talk about more on my thoughts on the market. This video is more tailored towards the stocks that I'm watching this week, not really the entire market. So go check that out if you guys are interested. So now that that's out of the way, we got to look at the futures. Let's take a look at some stocks and ETFs that I'm personally watching here, with the first one being Facebook, guys. And Facebook, I feel like ever since they reported their earnings a couple of weeks ago, I'm sure a lot of you guys remember, they reported earnings, they popped up to 216, which is an all-time high for Facebook. Actually, no, it's not an all-time high for Facebook. That is not correct. It was almost an all-time high for Facebook. We tested up here at 218. We hit that level back in July of 2018, so about a year ago from now. We hit that level, and ever since then, Facebook has dumped pretty aggressively. If we go back to that 184-hour chart, we can see from that peak, you know, down to about 183, that's about a 13-14% drop. And what I want to show you guys here, and what I want you to take a look at, is this trend line that I did end up drawing out here for Facebook. Take a look. We bottomed out at 122 back in December. We all remember that point in time when the markets were getting crushed, stocks were getting crushed. Facebook hit a low of 122. This was the bottom that we see here on the 6-month chart. And from there, We all remember the markets were recovering. Facebook went on a ridiculous rally, as a lot of the other stocks did as well, right? We started to run up. We started to make higher lows, higher highs. The price action was very positive. The stock just kept hitting highs, 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 right? We pulled back down. This was in the month of May, right? Stock saw a correction in the month of May as well. We pulled down and we held a higher low at about 162. We ran up. We saw the earnings. We hit 216 and now we pulled back down again. We got a double bottom, which is a very good sign of a potential bull run, right? A potential bullish reversal. But now we are trading below the 50 SMA, which has been a resistance over the past couple of trading weeks, as you guys can see, which in my opinion, if we break out of this, that's going to be very, very bullish. That's a very bullish move in my personal opinion. And if we do break out, guys, that's going to be the third higher low. That's going to be pretty much solidifying the uptrend on this trend line that we've drawn out here. So this is why I'm watching Facebook. You know, if we do something like this, right, even if it's a 2-3 day move, and you know, let's say the markets do end up pushing green this next day or two, right, the futures again are indicating that the markets are green right now, you know, let's say that runs for a day or two, Facebook can definitely see maybe a 4-5% run here, especially since it's been getting crushed so much over the past couple of weeks. So that's kind of what I'm watching here on Facebook. The technical break, again, I'm going to say it one more time, guys, is a break above this 50 SMA here on the 6-month chart. If we get that, I'm going to take a position in Facebook, no doubt about it. And from there, I'm going to mitigate my risk and, of course, let you guys know. And if we go to that, maybe the 20-day 1-hour chart, you guys can see it even better, right? On this chart, you can see the descending pattern Facebook's been on just based off of the move. Moving averages, right? The 50 SMA is this green line. The 180 SMA is the yellow line. You can clearly see we've been getting rejected by those levels. And a breakout, that's going to be very, very bullish. And you guys can see the line that I drew out here. If that ends up happening, guys, Facebook, I think I'm going to be going long, a 2-3, maybe a 4-day swing trade, depending on how the market plays out. Of course, if we get a trade war bombshell, if something crazy happens this upcoming week, that's going to go out the window, right? If that happens, stocks are definitely going to get hit hard again. And let's say the market in general just tanks, I do expect Facebook to tank as well, and then that plan yet again is going to be scrapped. But as of now, if the futures continue to move green, this could definitely play out. So another one I want to talk about is AT&T. And guys, AT&T has been absolutely crushing it. This stock has kind of been flying under the radar recently, honestly, over the past couple of weeks. Not a lot of people have been talking about it. I personally watch this one a lot because I am actually invested in this one in my long-term portfolio. But take a look at AT&T, guys. We hit $26 a share back in December. And at this point, the dividend yield was ridiculous. It was like 7 or 8% at this point. And from there, we saw a price appreciation in AT&T of about 21%. So in 8 months, guys, a 21% move in one of the largest companies, honestly. That's pretty remarkable, right? That's pretty, pretty remarkable. And during this time period, the moving averages, the yellow line here, the 180 SMA, the 50 SMA, which is the green line, both of these have been acting as support levels for the stock. And it seems like, you know, as a lot of these dividend companies, they're kind of similar, but AT&T, it seems like a lot of people have been flooding their money into this, you know, safer, quote unquote, dividend paying stock as the market, you know, has kind of been seeing some turmoil. And that's something that you see, right? A lot of the time, these safer dividend-paying companies like the Procter & Gambles of the world, AT&T, Johnson & Johnson, right? Think of these companies, McDonald's, Coca-Cola, the companies that don't have a crazy amount of growth, right? A lot of people flood their money here and view them as, you know, a safer place to have their money when, you know, there's a recession looming, to be completely honest with you guys, because that is what a lot of investors and traders are thinking right now. But in terms of a shorter term trade on AT&T, you know, at this point in time, we hit a high at about $35, right? And if we zoom out to the 3-year, week chart, you know, $35 is a point in time or a price point where we are, you know, roughly $34, $35. We are at a resistance. It's clear that we did break out of that resistance. So that's a good sign that we're looking to potentially hold that as a new support and then maybe advance to the next resistance, which at this point is around $36. But if we go back to that, 184 hour chart, let me pull it up very quickly for you guys. You can see that, honestly, guys, I would like to pull back and retest this point in time right here. The RSI is a bit overbought right now, right? We are at about $67, $70. And take a look at the pattern AT&T has been on. Every time it's hit a high, it's pulled back, whether it's 1, 2, 3%, it's corrected a bit, and it's retested the moving average as a support. So at this point, I would love to see a pullback and a test at $34-ish dollars again. That's going to put us at that 50 SMA and that long-term old resistance, now a new support at around $34. And if we do retest that, you know, this could be a great swing trade entry point where we could be filling the gap up to the next resistance, which I showed you guys on the longer term chart is around $36, and that offers about a 5% margin of profit here on AT&T. So I'm really liking that, guys. AT&T, this is one that I'm for sure watching here heading into these next couple of weeks in the stock market. So GRMN, this is one that one of my subscribers ended up calling out. I believe it was on the video on Saturday as well as the call out section in our Discord group chat. And if you guys have not yet joined our Discord group chat, that is linked down below. It's 100% free. We have about 800 people in that chat talking every single day about stocks, trading strategies, investing strategies, what's going on in the economy and the news. I highly recommend you guys get in there. I'm sure you'll love it. And let's get to the stock, guys. GRMN. So this is one that I was looking at a bit before recording this video, and it's quite obvious here that this stock is very choppy, it seems like, right? We're hitting $60, we run up to $90, we drop down to $76, we pop up to $82, right? We drop down at $75. This seems like a stock that's very difficult kind of to do technical analysis on. It's not like AT&T, which in my opinion is extremely easy to do technical analysis and kind of predict. This stock's kind of like a roller coaster. It's everywhere, right? GRMN. And if we pull up a bit of a longer term chart here, you can see one good thing that I noticed here is that we're pulling back down now to this 50 SMA support on the 3-year, 1-week chart. This is something that's attractive because notice how every single time we've pulled to that 50 SMA over the past 3 years, we've held that as a new support. We've bounced on top of it and we've hit a fresh new high. So now we hit that high at $90, right? You guys can clearly see the stock got a bit overinflated. Now it's coming back down to earth. We're testing that 50 SMA again. This was at about the end of July. And now we are seeing a bit of a pop here. And now take a look, guys. We have about a 13 to 14% margin of profit right now on GRMN. But I'm not going to pull the trigger quite yet on this particular stock until this happens, and I'm going to tell you right now what that is. Let's go to the 184 hour chart. You guys can clearly see ever since we've dropped from that $90 price point, the moving averages here, the yellow and the 50 and the green line, the 180 and the 50 SMA, these levels have been acting as resistance points. It's very obvious. Lower highs have been being made, lower lows. It's been a straight up downtrend over the past couple of months, really since the month of April in 2019, right? So I need to see, guys, I need to see a breakout above this trend line here, something like this, right? Into the $80, maybe mid 80s. At that point, we're going to be breaking out in the smaller time frame charts and really confirming the bounce on that 50 SMA on the 3-year, 1-week chart, which in my opinion is very critical right now for GRMN. And if we go a bit closer here, let's say to the 20-day, 1-hour chart, you guys can see it even clearer, right? Moving averages, they're acting as resistances. We need need to pop out. We need to break out here and honestly break into the mid-80s, in my opinion, before me even considering taking a position in GRMN. So that's kind of the gist on that. The next stock I want to talk about, and honestly, guys, a lot of the banking stocks have been getting cremated lately. They've been getting crushed. Bank of America, ticker symbol BAC. This stock's literally lost $5.04 to be exact over the past 17 days, pretty much since the beginning of August in 2019. That's absolutely ridiculous, right? So this stock's lost about 15% of its value. This is honestly maybe opening up a long-term position play here for you bank investors out there. But on a shorter-term basis here, BAC, if we get the handy-dandy support and resistance tool out here, you guys can see we're actually at a point in time where we've held above the level we're currently at multiple different times in the past. We held this level back in March, roughly at about $26, $27. You guys can see right here, we dumped literally from the same exact point at about $30 all the way down to $26. We held that point. We popped up to $31. We pulled back again in the end of May, and we held that same spot at $26. And what did we do after that? We ran all the way up to $31, and now we're pulling back down and we're holding that same exact spot. And honestly, this should have been the first or second stock that I talked about in this video, because this one honestly offers the most potential, maybe along with Facebook here, out of all the stocks that I'm going to be talking about in this video. Right now, this is a textbook horizontal pattern, guys. And for those of you guys that don't know what a horizontal pattern is, it's pretty much when a stock is trading, or an ETF is trading, between a set support level where it's bounced at multiple times in the past, and a set resistance where it's gotten rejected at multiple points in the past. And you guys can see we've gotten hit at $30 to $31 once, twice, three times, four times, five times, six times in the past six, seven, 8 months here, you know, pretty much since the beginning of 2019. And we've held 26, 27 once, twice, and now three times over the past same time period, right? The past six, seven, 8 months. So I think it's very possible here that Bank of America does see a bit of a breakout, but all we need to wait for is that clear sign of the breakout. And in my opinion, on the 20-day one-hour chart, you can clearly see we're kind of still downtrending, right? We're slowly breaking out of that 50 SMA. Ideally, I'd like to get a break above the 180 SMA, maybe back into the $28 level. And once we get in there, once we do, if we do, right, that's going to be a point in time where we can really capitalize on a 10% swing move if BAC does get back up to $30 to $31. And I personally love this call out, guys. Thank you so much. If you're watching this video, thank you so much for calling this one out. Honestly, let's take a look at some other bank stocks while we're at it. I'm sure a lot of the other ones have gotten killed too. You know, JP Morgan here, this is one that did get crushed about $10 over the past 18 days, 117 down to about 107. It's kind of in the same predicament here, right? We're holding that level of 107. We were at that level back in the end of May. And honestly, guys, if we do end up popping out of this 50 SMA resistance, right, into the 108s, 109s, maybe 110s, this could be a point where we do run up to 116 again, 115, and we can grab about a 6, 7%. But if we're looking at it at the margin of profit, BAC clearly offers a lot more than JP Morgan, which is why, honestly, on a risk-to-reward basis here, because whenever you, scan trades, look at trades, you always have to be like, okay, what is the risk with this trade? What's the reward? When you're looking at that, BAC, in my opinion, is beating out JP Morgan, because on reward basis here, you know, up to $31, that's about an 11-12% from where we're currently at here, roughly, right? And in terms of risk, you know, I would cut losses once we break this level if I do take a position. So from where we are now at about $27, there is about a 2-3% risk here on Bank of America, right? And that's where I'd cut my profits, so or my losses rather. So 12% risk or reward versus a 2-3% risk, that is very good. That's what I personally look for when I am trading stocks. So Bank of America, I love Bank of America heading into this week. Keep an eye on it, guys. I'm sure there's going to be a move. We just have to wait, time for it, time it correctly, and wait for the opportunity. Do not rush into it. That's what I'm going to be doing. So AMD is another one of those stocks, guys, that hit a high. It did very well for a little bit, and it's gotten crushed over the past couple of weeks. And you guys can clearly see from $35 down to where we bottomed out at about $31, that's about a 14-15% opening, a 14-15% profit margin that was opened. And on a technical level here, take a look what level we're holding at here. There was a resistance back in April. There was a resistance back towards the end of April and the beginning of May at about $29.75, $30, right? We broke that level, making it a new support. We retested it back in June. We broke up to 35, and now we're retesting that same level of support at around $30. We had a strong move on Friday of $1.51 and price change to the upside, up 5%. And that's giving me some confidence here that we are going to continue to rally here on AMD if the markets do continue to push green. If the markets get killed tomorrow, guys, it's very likely that AMD will get killed as well. But let's say markets do well over the next week. Let's say we see a bit of a breather, a bit of a recovery. You know, AMD can definitely run another 5, 6, 7%. This stock is known to get hot, right? And you can see on the 20-day 1 hour, we are seeing a bit of a breakout here. Notice how ever since we hit 35, we were getting rejected by that 50 SMA. We dumped a bit. EMA was acting as a resistance. Now we're starting to break out. The EMA is crossing above the 50 SMA, and for those of you guys that don't know, the EMA is the fastest reacting moving average, at least the way I have set it up here. And once that breaks above the other moving averages, that's a very bullish sign. That's a very bullish indicator that I personally use. And this gonna really end up leading into this upcoming week in terms of price action to the upside, right? So we're going to look for the continuation here. If we gap up tomorrow, maybe $31.90, maybe $32, this could be a very good entry point on Advanced Micro Devices, AMD. And I'm definitely watching that. So, guys, not a long list today of stocks, honestly. Facebook T, GRMN, BAC, and AMD. That's all I have listed here on this little envelope. But, of course, you guys know this, especially if you've been watching me for a while. I'm trading these market ETFs listed right here on a day-to-day basis for the most part, especially when the markets are volatile, right? So another scenario that I'm looking here, guys, or looking at here, right? You see the futures are up, right? So let's say, you know, markets do end up dumping. Let's say tomorrow we wake up and the futures are red. We're starting to see a bit of a pullback. If we go to the ES, you guys can see we're kind of at a point where we're in a wedge right now. So let's say we get rejected here and we start to break down. You know, this could be a point where the VIX pops. We're going to see volatility. Markets will go down, obviously, if we do end up breaking to the downside here. And TVIX is one that does very well when there's volatility when the markets are going down. And I've been trading this one a lot recently, as you guys have been seeing on my Instagram, which is linked down below at StasurFest. Go give me a follow on there. I've been trading this one a lot as the markets have been very, very volatile, right? So this one, you know, on the second theory of the markets potentially dropping this week, you know, you have to have options and plans for both market scenarios, right? If the market goes up and the market goes down, you have to realize how to make money in both of these situations. So let's say the market dumps, this is going to offer a lot of margin, upwards of 20-25%, ticker symbol TVIX. I'm watching this one very, very closely. SQQQ is another one. This one is not trading on the VIX, guys, but it's trading on the NASDAQ. Whenever the NASDAQ's going up, this one's going up, or rather, down, right? But whenever the NASDAQ is selling off, let's say the NASDAQ goes down 2%, this one's going to be up 6% because it's a 3x leveraged ETF. So this one's going to pop if the markets sell off. And typically when the markets are selling off, guys, the NASDAQ gets hit the hardest because tech typically gets hit the hardest. And since the NASDAQ's a tech-heavy index, you guys can make the correlation that the NASDAQ would get hit the hardest out of the three main indexes that I talk about on this channel. So those are a couple. Of course, TQQQ, which is the inverse to SQQQ. This one follows the NASDAQ. It goes up when the NASDAQ's going up. SPXL and SPXS, those trade on the S&P 500. I'm watching those as well. And of course, guys, gold has been hot. We talked about gold, I think, in yesterday's video. If we go to the 20-year, one-month chart, not the 184-hour chart, the 20-year, one-month chart, you guys can see we filled the gap that we called out about a month ago on gold from 1430 up to 1550-ish. We got rejected at 1550. Now I'm looking to see if we successfully break above 1550, hold that as new support before maybe even running up to the 1600s, guys. So gold, I'm watching that. Of course, crude oil, natural gas, UGAS, DGAS, DRIP, GUSH, all of those that we trade a bunch on the channel, all these inverse ETFs, I'm watching those as well. So that's it for today's video, guys. If you did enjoy it, feel free to go down below and hit that like button. If you want to see further content from me, consider subscribing, hit that notification bell so you're notified every single time that I do make a video, and drop a comment down below. Let me know your thoughts on the market, what you're trading, what stocks, ETFs you're watching, and where we're headed. Honestly, guys, I would love to know your opinion. You know I love chatting with you guys in the comment section. And if you guys want to be further connected, all the links, Instagram, Discord, Twitter, Facebook, all of those are linked down below. So feel free to stay connected there. I'll catch you all in the next video. Good luck next week, guys, or this week rather. Peace out.